Southeastern Conference. Number 5, LSU. And number 14, Arkansas. Coming to you live from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Welcome in, everyone. Alongside former All-Americans Lori Strong-Ballard and Kaylee Dixon-Abood, I'm Garrett Walbert. LSU is on a 7-match win streak heading into tonight's meet. They've been one of the most consistent programs in the nation, finishing as the NCAA runner-up 3 of the last 4 years. Veteran coach Dee Dee Brough, now in her 43rd season, has the Tigers ranked in the top 10 in all 4 disciplines. Lori, this week the NQS rankings came out. Tell us a little bit more about them.
Well, this is the first week of this season where rankings are not by average, but rather NQS, which is the national qualifying score. You take your top 6 scores, 3 of them must be away, you drop the high and the low, and you average the 4 in the middle. This will determine rankings for the rest of the season, as well as seedings going into the SEC and regional championships. And actually, LSU benefited from this format. This week they moved up in the rankings because they have some strong away scores, and you are required to have at least 3 road scores in that calculation.
Individually for LSU, Kaia Johnson has wowed audiences with her all-around exploits.
Kaia Johnson has been a freshman phenom for the LSU Tigers, one of their best ever. She is currently ranked number 2 in the nation in the all-around, number 1 on floor and 3rd on vault. Kaia is definitely a front runner for SEC Freshman of the Year. She has competed on all 4 events in every meet so far, so the coaching staff has decided to rest her a little bit tonight. We may only see her on 1, possibly 2 events. You know, she just celebrated her 18th birthday, so maybe a little bit of a birthday gift to allow her to rest her body so she can be at peak form for the end of the season when they really need her.
There's a new sheriff in Fayetteville. Arkansas makes a high-profile hire in Jordan Weber. Kaylee, tell us more about Coach Weber, who's been a winner at every level of competitive gymnastics.
Absolutely. Jordan Weber has had an outstanding competitive career as a gymnast, winning Olympic gold in 2012 with the Fierce 5. He was an all-around champion at the 2011 and 2012 World Championships. And then after her competitive career, she went on to UCLA, where she was the assistant coach, and she helped lead the Bruins to the 2018 National Championships. And now in her first year as a head coach in the NCAA, she is already making her mark on the Razorback program. She's hosted 3 top 10 crowds and helped lead the Razorbacks to 7 consecutive 196-plus scores. And tonight, she's looking to keep that streak alive.
Well, they have a very talented roster, and it's led by a sophomore in Kennedy Hambrick.
Kennedy Hambrick is one we need to watch out for. She earned her 3rd straight and 4th career all-around title this season, and she's currently ranked number 11 in the all-around in the NCAA.
LSU has a clear advantage in the all-time series with Arkansas, with 36 wins against 5 losses and 1 tie. Arkansas last beat LSU in 2012 in Fayetteville, and the Tigers have topped Arkansas in 18 consecutive meets. A beautiful setting for collegiate gymnastics here in Baton Rouge. Lori, LSU has packed the PMAC with over 11,000 fans per meet on average. This is one of the most exciting arenas in all of collegiate gymnastics.
This environment is electric, and these athletes love the passion and excitement that the fans bring. This is the place to be on a Friday night in Baton Rouge. It's a family-friendly environment and always super competitive. And I know as a former Georgia gym dog, this is one of the toughest venues to compete in. And Kaylee, I know the benefits that this brings to the home team. You know it very well.
Absolutely. It was so much fun to be in the PMAC on a Friday night in front of your home crowd. Everyone gets excited, everyone's on their feet cheering you on, and there's just nothing like it.
LSU ready to go on vault. Arkansas will lead off on bars in our first rotation. Coach Bob Moore dominating the vault again. 3 of the top 4 scorers in the SEC this year, Kaia Johnson, Kennedy Edney, and Sarah Edwards, have all posted scores of 9.95 or better. How does he continue to be so successful?
It's amazing. And LSU's ranked number 2 in the nation on vault. And they've had some obstacles to overcome over there. They lost one of their top vaulters, Sarah Edwards, a few weeks ago to an ankle injury. Tonight, one of their top, most powerful leadoff performers, Kai Rivers, is sick. She will not compete on any events tonight. And so they've had a tough time. Kaia Johnson tonight could be rested. She's slated to go last in this lineup, so they will use her only if needed. So all along, through all of those obstacles, they still remained a very prominent vaulting team.
Statistically, Arkansas is best on floor. They're ranked number 8 in the nation. But Kaylee, their second best discipline, the uneven bars, they're averaging 48.99 as a team.
Absolutely. And Chris Brooks is also new to the coaching staff at Arkansas, and he's done a fantastic job. with his bars lineup. So I'm excited to see what they're going to do here tonight.
We take a look at the vault lineup for LSU, leading off the freshman Lexi Nibbs, followed by Maddie Rao, Sammy Durandy, Ruby Harold, Kennedy Edney, and Kaya Johnson.
So you see Kennedy Edney in that fifth position. She is the national champion and usually anchors that lineup, but they today have put Kaya Johnson last up. Like we mentioned earlier, possibly resting her here. They will only use her if needed. Lexi Nibbs, a freshman, she cracked this lineup three times this season, averaging just below a 9.75. She's super powerful, but looking for a controlled landing here to score big. Nice job. Yurchenko left foot a little bit low on the chest on the landing, but pretty secure.
It's a nice leadoff vault, very, very consistent, and that's what you want as your leadoff person.
Now we take a look at the bars lineup for Arkansas. Jessica Yamzon will lead things off, one of the upperclassmen. Kiara Gianfunga, Haley Garner, as well as Bailey Lovett, who is a redshirt freshman. They'll finish off with Kennedy Hambrick and Sarah Schaefer.
And Arkansas struggled a little bit on bars last week early in the lineup. That may have cost them the win against Auburn, but their last two had clutch performances with nine nines.
Kachev. Last handstand down to the low bar to a bail handstand. She goes back up to the high bar for her dismount. Little short on that last handstand. Full twisting double layout. Small step on the landing, but overall not a bad routine. Some missed handstands here and there, but pretty solid start for Arkansas.
And Jessica has a solid role on this team. Not only does she compete in the all-around quite often, but she's leadoff on three of four events. And in your leadoff competitor, you want someone who is consistent, has experience, and will set this bar lineup up for success.
The senior from Las Vegas finishes back to LSU. And Maddie Rao, the freshman from Houston, Texas.
Maddie graduated early, joined this team just before season started, and has been in this lineup all along, competing a big Yurchenko 1.5. That is a 10-0 start value, just the step on the landing.
Once she controls that landing and gets the stick, that's going to put up a huge score for the Tigers.
She's been gaining some valuable competition experience under extreme pressure, competing in front of big crowds, and with each week, she will get a little bit more consistent and confident.
You can see the LSU fans have packed the PMAC to the rafters for tonight's match, the last in SEC play for LSU in 2020. And there's Coach Didi Bro. Now Kiara Gianfunga will come in. She's an all-arounder for them.
Her high score on bars for this season is a 9.875.
Last Friday night, this bars team scored a 49.425, which is a pretty solid score. And that's something that they're going to want to build on and get higher into that 49.56 range so that they can gain a competitive edge over their opponent. Bars and beam really are the make or break events in college gymnastics. So trying to get that 49.56 mark is really, really important.
She had to wait a little bit before saluting to the judges. You can see her taking a deep breath, shaking her arms, trying to get those nerves out before starting this routine. Ooh, big release move. That's called a ray. Just a little too late on the release. Takes her too far from the bar. That's a 5/10 deduction for a fall.
She's got a few seconds here. Gain her composure and finish the rest of her routine to the best of her ability.
Coach Chris Brooks giving her a lift up to the high bar. She will not repeat the element just in case she falls again. Instead, a toe hand, bail to handstand down to the low bar. That will give her connection bonus. Two giants into her dismount, a full twisting double back. Finds a perfect landing. Well done in recomposing herself and coming back strong for the rest of the routine.
It's always so hard to get it together after something like that happens at the beginning of the bar routine. And I think she did a fantastic job finishing that bar routine the best way she possibly could.
Nice finish there. LSU's Maddie Rao was credited with a 9-8-0.
Sammy Durante competing at Yurchenko full small hop on the landing. She gets some amazing distance on that vault.
She had a lot of height, a lot of power. Tiny pike down, which paused that hop back. Once she lays that thing out and goes for the stick, that should go 9-9 every time.
Absolutely. A Yurchenko layout full is scored out of a 9.95, so that's the highest score she can get on this vault. Pretty clean in the air in terms of her body position, but like you said, a little bit of a pike down causing her to bounce back on the landing.
Sammy now performing in three events for LSU. She was all freshman in 2018. Here's Haley Garner, the senior from Memphis, Tennessee.
It's going to be up to Haley to kind of pick up that momentum that was lost with that miss in that last routine. So she's got to reset the tone. It's like she's first, so that everybody else follows and they can have a good five scores to put up for a solid bar score.
In college gymnastics, six athletes compete in a lineup, but your five top scores count, so you can drop a low score or a mistake. That's the greatest thing about college gymnastics, is that whole team aspect of it, knowing that if I make a mistake, my teammates can pick up, or maybe I have to pick up and help my teammates.
Garner was all SEC as a freshman and sophomore, won her first career event title against LSU. She scored a 9-9-0 on bars.
Taking a deep breath, going through a couple last-minute cues before she mounts off the board. Kip hand on the high bar. Giant full, finishing nicely on top, right into a release move. It's called a ginger into another release move, a shoot over down to the low bar. It's important to hit those handstands, maybe a little short on that one. Well done on the giant full, finishing it vertical, almost sticks the landing.
And that was a beautiful routine. Very well done, nice form, big releases.
It was very precise and calm and disciplined. She was definitely taking one skill at a time, finishing each one to its fullest before moving on to the technique of the next one.
Now here's Ruby Harold, a versatile competitor for LSU, vaulting in the fourth spot for the Tigers.
She has a big, difficult, risky vault. The Yurchenko 1.5 with a blind landing. Can she find it? Oh, steps out on the landing, but it was huge. Just a massive, powerful vault.
Ruby's ranked number 15 in the country on this event, and it's because of how high and powerful and the distance that she gets.
She has scored a 9.95 and a 9.975 on this vault. And again, it's a blind landing. You can't see the floor before the feet hit, so it's all about timing. It's all about the technique and the direction that you get off the vaulting table.
Now Arkansas will bring Sarah Schaefer to work the bars. 9.875, her career high. Oh, make that Bailey Lovett. Lovett will lead off. Lovett is one of four freshmen who has worked her way into the lineup for tonight's meet against LSU.
Vault score for the Tigers, Ruby Harold, 9.875. Next on the uneven bars for Arkansas, Bailey Lovett.
Scored a 9.875 last week. That's her season high, and she scored it four times this year, so she is a solid bar worker. Her major release move is a Ray. We saw Kiera miss it earlier in the lineup. Oh dear, in trouble from the beginning, going over on her handstand. We'll see how she can cover up here. Wow, nice job. Oh, giant half. Will she go for the Ray? Yes, that is an amazing cover-up.
That is some fight. She's trying her best, but just couldn't get it together. Bars is all about timing. It's all about your swing, and she went for that release move and then just kind of crumbled after that. But let's hope she can take a deep breath here and finish to the best of her ability. That way, if her score gets to count, it won't be too bad for Arkansas bars lineup.
I'm kind of blown away because a Ray is an E-level skill, one of the most difficult release moves you can do on bars. And the fact that she went over on a handstand, covered it up with a giant half, added another toe hand and still went for the Ray and caught it. It was absolutely outstanding, but you could tell she was just off her game, missed another handstand. Had to take the fall anyways.
She can finish with a stuck landing here. Giant full. A double tuck. Small hop. Not the routine she wanted, that's for sure, but she recovered and made it through.
A nice recovery there for Bailey Lovett, the freshman from Greensboro, North Carolina.
And next up, ball team, for your Fighting Tigers.
Up next for LSU, Maya Johnson will move up in the order.
A couple steps on landings have now pushed LSU to go ahead and put their freshman phenom in. Kaya Johnson, she can compete a Yurchenko double full today. She does the easier Yurchenko full, and it's just huge. You can tell why she does the double full.
Absolutely. She landed at the back of that landing mat, which just shows how much power this athlete really has. This vault is a timer for her. It's very easy.
They actually reduced her warm-up today just, again, to try and save her body, allow it to rest. She didn't do the long warm-up. She just did the touch warm-up, the 30-second touch. So big-time competitor here coming out for her team when they needed it.
Kaya already has a pair of perfect 10s as a true freshman. She carted a 10 on beam at Florida and was perfect on vault at the gym quarters. Now Kennedy Hambrick, who's won several all-around titles for the Arkansas Razorbacks in a row, will head to the bars.
She's been the Razorbacks' top bar scorer four times this season, including a 9-9 last week.
Ball score for the Tigers, Kaya Johnson, 9-8-2-5.
Definitely feeling the pressure right now to get her team back on track after a couple mistakes. Chris Brooks getting into her ear, trying to keep her calm, try to keep her focused. This is an event that she can hit.
Judges are talking about that last routine. There was a lot that went on, so they want to make sure they give the athlete an accurate score.
There are the two judges there comparing their notes, making sure that they are on the same page.
Remember, there is no instant replay in gymnastics, so it's up to the judges to remember what they saw, remember what exactly went into that mishap that happened on the high bar.
Everything was happening so quickly and so different than a bar routine that they're normally used to seeing. The judges actually write down the skills in shorthand, so they have to go back and go through their shorthand to see what skills they had, what kind of bonus is in the routine. They have to come up with a start value for this routine as well as the deductions.
Hambrick certainly has a high top end. Last year, all SEC honors as a freshman in her career high came against LSU with a 9.90. But again, just kind of in a holding pattern, how tough is this for her?
It's very tough to just stand there and wait. You're ready to go. You're gripped up. You're chalked up. You're mentally prepared. And then you're kind of frozen and you kind of get cold. So you just got to stay within yourself and try not to think about what's going on. You just got to focus on your routine.
And keep in mind, she's already fifth in the lineup. So she has been standing on the side waiting already. And this bar event has gone by a little bit slow, so she just needs to focus and know that she's done this routine a million times and she can get it done.
Next on the uneven bars for Arkansas, Kennedy Hambrick.
Doing some visuals before she mounts. Very calm in her approach. Nice aggressive handstand. Blind change into a piked Jaeger, rotates a little slow, has just enough momentum to do that overshoot down to the low bar. Aggressive again in the handstand, I like it. Two giants, full twisting, double back, small hop on the landing. She had great composure through all of that, having to wait, and came through with a big time routine for Arkansas.
And now, the anchor of your LSU ball team, please welcome Kennedy.
Here's that pike Jaeger right into the immediate toe shoot. Legs glued together, beautiful toe point. And then the full out, tiny hop on the landing, but a great routine.
Now the first time we'll see her tonight, the 17-time All-American, two-time national champion on vault, Kennedy Edney.
LSU changed their lineup. They left their national champion as the anchor in a massive Yurchenko 1.5, one step on the landing.
Kennedy's just an amazing athlete. No matter the event, vault bars, beam floor, you can count on power, you can count on height and consistency.
She definitely has some nerves of steel as well and competes so well.
Her hands got a little far back on the table, so wasn't as good as I've seen her do it, but still a very nice Yurchenko 4.5.
It's amazing she got that much power out of that vault as well. She had a little bit of a closed shoulder angle. They like to see those shoulders open so that it goes up a little bit more, and then she can get that solid landing.
Edney is scheduled to compete in the all-around tonight. Now Sarah Schaefer takes the bars.
Toe hand release move up to the high bar. Back down to the low bar for a bail to handstand. You see Chris Brooks stepping in there just in case on that difficult skill from high to low. A coach can be there for safety reasons. As long as he does not touch her, it won't be a deduction. Nice job on the double layout, just a small hop on the landing.
That replay, there's the Shaposh up to the high bar, right back down to the low bar, bail handstand, beautifully done. It was right on top, and then that double A dismount, small hop on the landing, but a solid anchor bar routine.
Looks like the highest score for LSU on vault through the rotation was a 9.875 by Ruby Harrell. First rotation is in the books here in the PMAC. We'll step aside and come back. Thank you for joining us. We'll be back with more on the ESPN SEC Network when we return. One rotation against the Arkansas Razorbacks, a nice top 15 matchup. Let's take a look now at LSU's opening vault scores, 1-6 up on the board for the Tigers. Lori, what stood out to you?
I felt like LSU was a little conservative tonight on vault, maybe just trying to land the vault rather than stick it about a tenth below their potential on each of these vaults because of landing errors.
You see the lowest score drop, so Lexi Nibbs is erased. Now, the Gymbacks bars routines, and Akin, they had a drop or two there, so tough for them, Kaylee.
Absolutely. They definitely did not want that to be their bar rotation with two falls and having to count one of them. However, they can recover. We still have three events left for them to kind of make up some ground on.
Well, both these teams will switch rotation two coming up. We can't wait to see LSU on bars and Arkansas running down the gangway on vault. We'll have more when we return here, LSU and Arkansas, on a Friday night. It's Friday night meet. Arkansas with a 48-425 on bars.
Let's hear it one more time.
Nice crowd inside the Maravich Assembly Center. Let's take a look at the Road to Nationals rankings and every SEC team ranked in the top 20 this year.
Yeah, all eight SEC teams are in the top 20, once again showing that the SEC is a powerhouse conference. It's that kind of competition week in and week out that strengthens these teams. Oklahoma at the top of the list here. They've scored over a 198 a couple times this year. They will definitely be the team to beat. Florida's having a nice year as well.
Then you see Auburn at number 15, and then we round out at number 20 with Missouri.
So a nice grouping of collegiate gymnastics programs in the Road to Nationals. We're getting ready for the second rotation. Arkansas warming up on vault, LSU warming up on bars. Two of the top five bars workers in the SEC, Sammy Durante and Ruby Harrell. They give LSU a strong 1-2 punch, both of them ranked in the top five in the conference.
LSU's ranked number 4 on bars, and that 1-2 punch definitely helps them considering they graduated some very talented athletes, including the national champion, two-time national champion, Sarah Finnegan, last year. So several athletes have really stepped their game up on this event to keep them strong on bars.
Sarah Schaefer leads the Gymbacks on vault. There's Coach Bro. Talk about an incredible career, 43 years young for Coach Bro, who's done everything but win a team national championship. And for LSU to finish as the NCAA runner-up 3 of the last 4 seasons, she's always talked about you have to be in the conversation to win a national championship. LSU has firmly put themselves there. Arkansas really wants to have a nice bounce back here. I think they want to look strong on vault. It's one of their better disciplines, and they're ready to get things going now with Jessica Yamzon, who leads off all 4 events for them.
Arkansas is ranked 27th in the nation on vault. They're at a little bit of a deficit compared to LSU in terms of their start values. But today we saw LSU make mistakes on landing. So if Arkansas can be clean, then they can really up their ability to score well on this event. Have clean landings. That's important.
It'll be Kiara Gianfagna who will lead off tonight. They were scheduled to have Jessica Yams on, but Gianfagna will lead things off. She has a career high of 9.75 on vault.
Competing, Yurchenko layout, full small hop on the landing, a 9.95 start value. Solid start.
And first of the uneven bars for your fighting Tigers.
Nice to see Kaya Johnson leading things off for LSU.
Unfortunately, this will be the last we will see her tonight. We mentioned them resting her, so just competing vault and bars tonight. Filling that leadoff role that Sammy Durante has held for the last couple years, an important position. You always want someone who is consistent, a really good competitor.
The tone for the rest of the bar lineup, so it's so important to have consistency in that spot. And I don't think you could ask for much better from Kaya Johnson. That bar routine was beautiful. She stuck the landing, hit her handstands, and I think that set the tone in the perfect way for this bar lineup.
Head coach Didi Bro says that Kaya is mature beyond her years, and that shows in the confidence that she has in her gymnastics. She knows her body, she knows her gymnastics, and that's why she can execute so well consistently under pressure.
Johnson's career high after eight meets at LSU on bars is as a 9.90. She may have just matched it. Here's Madison Hickey, another freshman in the lineup.
Also competing, Yurchenko, layout full. Nice job.
She's got a lot of distance on that vault. She landed in the back of the mat. Chest was down a little bit, not enough power, but overall, very, very solid vault.
You see Chris Brooks in the back of the vaulting landing, getting very excited when his athletes are nailing these vaults.
So Hickey, the freshman from Sycamore, Illinois, is finished. Now Bridget Dean ready to work bars for LSU.
Bridget got a 9.825 last Friday when LSU was at Missouri.
Bridget has improved so much on this event as well. She's definitely cleaned up this routine. She has a big major release move here at the beginning. It's a ray. She catches it. That was the skill that Arkansas had some struggles with. Back down to the low bar, nice and clean on the bail to handstand. Hit the vertical handstand. Big swing into the dismount. A double layout. Nails it. Absolutely stunning. Week in and week out, she just seems to be getting better and better and more confident.
Definitely the confidence in her gymnastics. You can tell by the way she executed those handstands. They weren't short. She went for them. She wasn't afraid to fall over. And then the icing on the cake was this stuck dismount. Beautiful double layout. Beautiful routine.
I am telling you, the PMAC exploded, and she's got the crown to show for it. Now Claire Rogers, the freshman from Kansas City, Missouri.
Back in the lineup today after competing vault in the first five meets of the season. Yurchenko layout full, little low with the chest. She's really trying to absorb and hold on to that stuck landing, but has to take the step.
Hands were a little on the front of that table, caused her to not get as good of a block and not a lot of distance. You want your hands in the middle of the table. That way you can really block and explode off the horse and have a nice landing.
Alona Shinnikova, the freshman from Evergreen, Colorado, ready now on bars.
Still somewhat recovering from Achilles tendon tear that she experienced before coming to LSU. She was a little bit of a late signee. This is a very difficult routine. Three directly connected release moves. You don't see many athletes in the country doing this kind of difficulty. Beautiful job hitting that handstand. Comes out a little long on the dismount. has to hop on the landing. But what an amazing routine. And when she can get that landing, this is going to score big time.
She has also gotten a lot more confidence. As a freshman coming in, you're not sure what to expect. There's a lot of different pressure on you when you're competing. And week after week, she's gotten more consistent, and now she's just fine-tuning those little mistakes.
You're right, Kaylee. A 9.95 in two of the last 3 weeks for Shinnecobah. She's helping solidify one of the better bars lineups in the SEC. Now Sarah Schaefer for Arkansas will head to the front of the vault.
Her high score is a 9.9 this season. She competes a blind landing vault as well. It's the Yurchenko layout half. So difficult. Because, like I mentioned before, with the 1.5, you can't see the mat before your feet hit. But she has such great timing and awareness that she usually sticks this vault every time.
She had a lot of height, a lot of distance, and pretty good form in the air, too. So that should put up a good score.
Congratulations to Bridget Dean, a career-high 9.9 on bars. And Kaya Johnson was awarded a 9.95, a new career-high for her. Not a bad start.
To lead off with a 9.95, that is amazing. And we talked about setting the tone. I think that set the tone for this bar lineup.
I also think she's a big competitor. She might be a little disappointed tonight that she's only doing two events, so she decided she was going to put up a big score here on bars.
Make it count.
Yes. Sammy Durante has so much ability on this event. Gorgeous lines, beautiful toe point. Giant half into a sky-high Jaeger. Back to handstand, snapping those feet together in the vertical position, into a pack salto, down to the low bar. Gorgeous pirouette, finishing in handstand. Last handstand's good. Just the landing here, big tap into a full twisting double back, looks for it, and sticks it.
She'll be knocking out the door at a perfect 10. All I saw was that landing. Her handstands were beautiful. Her form is beautiful. Her lines. Career high is a 9.95. So if it's not anytime soon, I'd be shocked.
She's matched that score in two of the last 3 weeks. Pretty impressive for the junior, who's now working three events for LSU. Kennedy Hambrick, all-around sensation for Arkansas, off to vault.
Powerful run. Yurchenko, 1.5, going for the big difficulty. Huge distance from the vault table to the landing, just a little short on rotation and maybe a little short on height. Creating power in the run. Huge, powerful hurdle. That then made her go very long, almost misses her hands on the end of the vaulting table. That can get a little bit scary, but pulls out one of the toughest vaults in collegiate gymnastics, the Yurchenko 1.5.
For her hands being that far on the table, that vault was pretty good.
Now Kennedy Edney for LSU, averaging a 9.85 on bars in her senior season. Where has the time gone? Just she and Ruby Harreld in the senior class this year for LSU.
And next up on the uneven bars.
I remember her first meet ever coming out on vault, nailing a Yurchenko 1.5, and I knew that she was going to have a fantastic and stellar career here. She injured her elbow earlier this year, was out of a couple of the lineups, especially here on bars. You can imagine bars be a difficult event with an injured elbow. So good to see her back in the lineup. She opens with a major release move here. It's called a Hindorf, similar to the Ray, but it's from the clear hip position. Nice job on her bail to handstand. She has one of the prettiest double layout dismounts simply because of the shape that she holds in the air. It's not arched, it's not pike, it is stick straight, and she sticks the landing.
That was a beautiful routine from Kennedy Edney. She's excited about it.
Kennedy's been a first-team All-American all three seasons at LSU, probably gunning for another award at the end of the season.
Her release move, hip cast handstand right on top. And then that beautiful double layout dismount with a stuck dismount.
Definitely in the running for Gymnast of the Year, perhaps.
Now the sophomore from Austin, Texas, Amanda Elswick. You might remember Elswick's sister, Heather, was an All-SEC Gymnast for the Razorbacks.
Super strong vaulter, competing the Yurchenko 1.5. Beautiful job.
really was a really well-done vault. In really nice form, a lot of height. There's the replay. Small hop on the landing, but that was about it.
We talked about the blind landing, but look here. She does the full, looks for the landing, and then completes the half. That's how you sort of get away with that blind landing.
Elswick had a 9.90 as a career high. We'll see what the score comes back that time. Now Ruby Harrell for LSU to close out Bars.
Ruby has one of the most unique bar routines in collegiate gymnastics. You'll see a very interesting skill right here. She shoots from high bar down to low bar. It's called a Schluterin. No one else in the country is competing that. Two-time Olympian for her country, Great Britain. Just the dismount, double front, tiny step on the landing.
From her freshman year to now her senior year, that bar routine has gotten so much more consistent, so much more confident. You can see it in the way she executes every single skill.
She knows exactly where she is. Everything is sharp and crisp. Double front, opens up for the landing, just a small step.
Nice showing on bars for the LSU Tigers. Several 9.9 pluses from Kaya Johnson, Bridget Dean, and Kennedy Edney, who had a 9.925. We'll let them change places. When we come back, we'll have our third rotation here inside the PMAC. You're watching the ESPN SEC Network on Friday night. Saw after two rotations, a chance to take a look at the Fighting Tigers scores on bars, which were very positive. They had a nice bounce back. We'll start off with Arkansas, the Gymbacks, with their vault rotation.
Well, like LSU, they had some deductions on their landings, a few that were piking down, causing those landing errors. I was impressed that they increased their difficulty a little bit with two athletes competing, Yurchenko 1.5. Once they can dial in the details there, that score will go up.
And now LSU, several career highs.
LSU had an outstanding bar rotation. 49.525, that's right where you want to be for your team total to be where you want it at the end of the evening. Kaya Johnson started off with a 9.95, followed by Bridget Dean's 9.9, Kennedy Edney 9.925. I mean, you couldn't ask for much more. Hit handstands, stuck landings, a really great bar rotation.
Kaylee, I think for Kaya Johnson now, she has a 9.95 in all four disciplines as a freshman.
She's just getting started.
I think you're right.
Just getting started. I'm excited to see where she goes.
We've got more to come. LSU and Arkansas heading for the third rotation. It'll be the Tigers on beam and Arkansas on floor, where they're top 10 in the country. Welcome you back inside the PMAC in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. A 98.625 for LSU and Arkansas with a 97.275 heading into their best event of the season. Ladies, coming up in just 2 weeks will be the SEC Championships in Duluth, Georgia. What's going through everyone's mind right now? You have to kind of think ahead and get ready for that big SEC tournament.
Absolutely. Actually, I think that this is one of the most difficult times of the year because you are so far into the season that you want to be dialing in all of those little details, the stuck landings, the hit handstands, the gorgeous no-wobble beam routines. But at the same time, you have athletes who are fatigued. You have athletes who are dealing with chronic injuries and that type of thing. So sometimes you have to back off training a little bit, sometimes rest your athletes like we're seeing them rest Kaya Johnson today. But at the same time, be pushing forward because LSU wants to come to SEC strong again. They are the three-time defending SEC champions, and they want to be in the game.
Kaylee, you know the SEC tournament is the premier conference tournament in all across the country, just top 10 teams everywhere you look.
Absolutely. Dee Dee always used to say that when we go to SECs, it's like the NCAA championships, if not a little bit more difficult because everybody in that competition is good. Everybody is there for one reason, and there's just great gymnastics in the SEC. So it really is good to prepare the athletes for the NCAA championships.
Nice day for associate head coach of LSU, Jay Clark, a season high for his bars routines, 49.525. Pretty impressive.
They had an amazing, outstanding effort over on bars today, and they led off with Akiah Johnson scoring a 9.95. Like you said, now she has a 9.95 score on every event as a freshman. Just a standout performance from top to bottom with that bar rotation.
So LSU heading to Beam, and we'll have a new player, Alona Shinnikova, getting her first start on Beam this year. We'll be excited to see her. She's slated in the four spot. Tough to not have Kai Rivers in the rotation for LSU tonight on Beam. She was averaging a 9.88 in her freshman year. Leading off, you see the Beam lineup will be Christina Desiderio in her junior season.
And Kai Rivers actually has been sick the last couple days. She's not even here in the arena. They made her stay home and rest and get better. Christina Desiderio missed 3 weeks straight in January because of a hip injury. She plays a very important role in this Beam lineup as the leadoff. We've talked about it before, how important it is to really set that tone and build confidence within your team.
Christina went 9.85 last week at Missouri. Little problem on that leap and jump connection. Kind of dropped her shoulder, had to take the wobble.
It's one of the most difficult leap connections you can do. A switch leap, which is a C skill, into the switch half, which is an E skill. She drops her chest on that a little bit on that very difficult E switch half.
Stuck the dismount. A very nice leadoff Beam routine. Had a few wobbles here and there, but overall a decent set.
What was nice to see is that she never panicked within the routine. She knew exactly where she was. She dropped her chest a little bit, but held on to a minor deduction for that wobble.
The lineup for Arkansas on floor, Kiara Jafania, Madison Hickey, Sarah Schaefer, along with Kennedy Hambrick, Bailey Lovett, and Sophia Carter.
Opening pass, nice set into her double pike and a solid landing. This is Arkansas's best event. They're ranked eighth in the country. Head coach Jordan Weaver was an assistant with UCLA for 6 years. Of course, after having a stunning elite career, Olympic, world, and national champion. So she brings a very nice eye, especially on this event. That attention to the choreography and the performance is outstanding. Little details like this, playing up the music, including your teammates into the routine on the sideline, it just adds a little extra to the routine.
Especially when you're not in front of your home crowd, you have to have your teammates there cheering you on because the home crowd's going to be cheering them on when they're back in Arkansas. So kind of feel out of place when you're not in your own element. So your teammates kind of help bring that atmosphere to you. Goes for that final tumbling pass. Double tuck. Kind of rebounded out of that landing. She had a lot of power.
Kiara's career high on floor is a 9.875. That was a nice routine.
And watching them in warm-up, you mentioned the power. They were very powerful. These double backs were sky high. And it looked like they were really paying attention to getting those landings stuck, really absorbing. But you could see here on that last tumbling pass, she landed on her heels and then bounced backwards. It's so hard to control that.
Now the Fort Myers native, Bridget Dean for LSU.
Bridget went 9.85 last week at Missouri.
She has a very difficult tumble series coming up here. It's an aerial into a back handspring, and what makes it difficult is the turning aspect of that first skill right here into the back handspring. Anytime you turn on a 4-inch wide beam, you're adding risk.
And she does it so well.
Pretty good execution, especially on the switch leap into a split jump quarter. The judges are looking for the hips to rise as well as 180-degree split. Beautiful front aerial into a solid split jump.
You can tell in her dance how confident she is. From her fingers to her toes, her chin pop, everything she does, she's executing it very well.
Difficult side aerial into the dismount. Aerial to a full twist. Sticks the landing. I have to say that's probably one of the best beam routines I've seen her perform.
I would agree. Definitely agree. That was beautiful.
See her get the stick crown at the end of the routine. That is something that LSU does to sort of celebrate and reward those stuck landings. They're so important. When you have five scores counting, all with landings, that's potentially 5 tenths deduction if you take a step on each one.
And it's an easy thing to fix, to get those tenths back in your pocket.
Now here's Madison Hickey.
First pass, round off back handspring, double pike, a little bit over rotated, slightly out of control on the landing. You can see she has a 4-inch mat as a landing precaution. That just helps take away a little bit of that ankle sting, and it is not a deduction.
The landings can really get hard on your body, especially in the competition arena when they're not as forgiving. You're not going into pit surfaces like you are in practice, and it wears on your body.
Hickey, still just a freshman, competed in the first two floor events of the year, scoring a 9.75. Back in the lineup tonight.
I did not have her originally slated in this lineup tonight, so she may have been a last-minute addition. Quite often, teams will warm up more than six athletes, and they just take a look to see who is performing, who is on tonight, and then they can make last-minute decisions to put their best athletes in their lineup.
And it's also good to exercise that depth, to see who you have, who's ready, how they're going to do under pressure, if you should need them, especially in postseason.
And to encourage the athletes to be ready to compete at all times. 1.5 front layout into a stag jump. Lost a little momentum there, but a pretty solid routine.
Now here's Sammy Durante on beam. She notched a 9.90 in Gainesville against the Gators.
Just like on bar, she has a beautiful look on this event. Take a look at that gorgeous toe point. Her lines are exceptional. Tumble series here, not taking a break to wait. Back handspring layout, trying to be disciplined with the arms and holding on to that landing. There is a deduction for more than 2 second pause before each skill, doing a good job of keeping the flow of the routine going here.
Jump connection, that is also something that is required. Two leaps or jumps directly connected.
I feel like the series threw her off a little bit, maybe brought some nerves to the surface here. She's just been slightly off on a few of her landings, but because of the training that she's been put through, she's been able to minimize the deductions.
That front aerial directly into a split jump. She kind of dropped her shoulder, but she kept her momentum going, getting that connection, and then the dismount.
Sure has been fun to watch her career grow from just working bars as a freshman, bars and beam last year. Now she's performing on vault. Now Sarah Schaefer on floor. The former SEC Freshman of the Year ready for her first pass.
Beautiful gymnast. Powerful, elegant. Her high score on this event is a 9.9, sky high, double pike, legs glued together.
She goes for that second tumbling pass. Double tuck, opened up for that landing.
Her hands are beautiful all the way through to her fingers. Sort of adds an extra fullness to the choreography.
And the judges are looking at the choreography, at the artistry, making sure that the athlete is performing, being exciting, they're not bored watching it, so they do take the choreography into consideration while judging.
Lost a little control there in her lead pass. Floratine is a minute and a half long, so these final tumbling passes are the most difficult in terms of endurance. No problem on the one and a half front layout.
And they make it look easy, but it is not easy finishing that final tumbling pass. You are very tired.
And we talked about this time of the year where the endurance should be there, but the fatigue is setting in. So sometimes you start to second guess your body a little bit. No problem there, and her one and a half to a front layout. Clean third tumbling pass.
Schaefer, one of the taller gymnasts you'll see at 5'9". Nice routine. And Shinnikova just drew a gasp from the crowd here at the PMAC.
Well, this is the first time that she has competed on beam, so they have never seen that mount before. It is very unique, very risky. This is a super risky skill. It's called an Anodi. It's a half turn to a front walkover. It is named after Henrietta Anodi from Hungary, gymnast who competed at the Olympic Games back in my day, many, many years ago. Nice job on her back handspring layout, just a slight wobble. Again, she is making her balance beam collegiate debut right here.
And she looks very calm, but believe me, getting up there for your first time, you are nervous, and she's calming her nerves very well. She does have a lot of experience at the elite level, so she's used to this kind of pressure, but she's doing a fantastic job. Chest down on the landing, kind of had to take what I like to call the college stick.
Yeah.
Kind of faked it, but overall a very nice first time out.
There's that unique mount, a back handspring basically to a shoulder stand. It absolutely got some gas from this crowd. And here's the Anodi. She jumps with a half turn, reaches for the beam into a front walkover. It is super risky and difficult.
You can see the smiles on LSU's team. They love seeing her for the very first time. Now Kennedy Hambrick ready to impress on the floor for Arkansas.
That was a huge double tuck. Spotted the landing perfectly. And you have to remember, this is Arkansas's, some of them, their first time on this floor. Every floor is a little different, so trying to find those floor landings is very difficult.
Rudy into a back layout, got a little out of control on her stag jump.
Kennedy has scored a 9.85 or higher in 7 of her 8 floor routines, dating back to the start of this season.
Some great unique choreography in this routine and lots of attitude. The music is powerful. It matches her style, her big, powerful tumbling.
Picking music that you like and that fits your personality really helps because it gets you pumped up for your floor routine, for your tumbling passes, and ultimately you'll perform it much better. Came up a little short on that double pike, probably a little tired at the end of that floor routine, but overall a decent set.
Arkansas is actually ranked higher than LSU on this event. They have some pretty routines and some pretty tumbling, but their difficulty overall is a little bit below what LSU does. So I think once you get to some of those bigger meets like national championships or regionals, I think when you are doing the bigger difficulty, if LSU can execute, that they will elevate their scores.
Kennedy Edney on balance beam for LSU. Beautiful front aerial into a Sassone. Her tumbling on beam, it's like she's not even on 4 inches. sky high back handspring layout step out, and my favorite is her front toss that she does in the pike position. Here it comes right after her leap series. Full turn, another required element. Again, looks very easy, but it is very difficult and very nerve-wracking to do on one foot. There it is, that pike front toss.
Usually has those cat-like reflexes for the landing. Just a tiny hop on the round-off, 1.5. I really feel like that small hop was the only deduction in that routine.
It was a great beam routine.
Back handspring layout. Strong push through the legs, getting fully straight. Nice height into it, and there's the dismount. A little crooked on the round off, so she took the 1.5 around the side and has small hop.
You cannot say enough about her dedication to compete the all-around for 4 seasons for LSU. She has answered the bell for the Tigers. Now Bailey Lovett, the redshirt freshman, will lead off for Arkansas.
This is one of Bailey's best. She's ranked number 16 on this event in the country. And that
absolutely
was a beautiful double layout.
Gorgeous double layout. We talked about their difficulty being a little bit lower. They've upped the ante here, opening with a sky-high E, the most difficult tumbling pass you can do. Oh, super clean on that double salto pass.
Lovett's performance against Auburn last week might have been her best as a Razorback. A 9.925 on floor, a 9.85 on beam.
Gorgeous amplitude on that leap series. Very patient in getting the lift into it, squaring up the turn, and then snapping into that split position.
Breath before this next tumbling pass. A huge double tuck, very nice.
The best tumblers usually have really solid round-off back handspring skills, and if you take a look at, that's the two skills that precede the big tumbling skill. You can see how she pushes through her legs to create that power in the back handspring, kind of makes it a little bit long, and that gives her that amplitude and power in the tumbling.
Now Reagan Campbell anchoring on beam for LSU.
Showing off her unique mount. Now right into her tumble series, back handspring layout, dancing out of it to avoid the wobble.
9.975 is Reagan's career high, so I think we'll be seeing a 10 sometime soon from her. Her beam is just beautiful. Her skills, her rhythm, her leaps.
The flexibility in those leaps. If you were to do a still shot at the top of the leap, she would definitely be in oversplit position. Sometimes has difficulty squaring up that switch half. No problem today. She competes beam and floor only, but beam is definitely her forte. Dismount. Beautiful pop and direction into that double full, and that's why she gets the stick landing.
How about it, Tiger Man?
She just flows through this routine like she's doing it in her sleep. She's done it a million times. The confidence is there. The rhythm is exceptional. And look at that dismount. A square round off. She pops off her toes. Direction is good. Landing is perfect.
Congratulations to Bailey Lovett, who scores a 9.9 on floor. The first 9.9 for Arkansas in the meet. Now Sophia Carter will finish things off from Blue Springs, Missouri.
So we saw some big tumbling from Bailey Lovett. Now we're going to see some of the most exceptional choreography and showmanship. She is absolutely stunning in the dance aspect of this routine.
She's an All-American on floor, too, so I'm expecting some big things from her.
There's a cameraman on the side of the floor, and you saw her make eye contact, flirty eyes with the cameraman. That's how special she is on this event. She just oozes personality and performance.
She's got a great routine going so far, controlling her landings, showing off her dance and her flexibility.
Just watch her arms, the execution there, the amplitude, everything is fully extended and it's absolutely gorgeous. Of course, the use of the eyes throughout the routine adds another layer. Last pass, double pike, big finish.
That was a beautiful floor routine. I did not see many deductions, if any, in that. Great, great routine from Sophia.
Carter won 12 event titles as a sophomore. Very clean there.
9.975.
Round off back handspring, sky high, double tuck, legs are glued together, and a big finish and a smile on her face. The performance was taken to another level throughout this routine.
You can just see the joy on her face there. Very nice finish. More good news for LSU. Reagan Campbell, you mentioned she might go 10 someday. She ties a career high with a 9.975 on beam to anchor for LSU. We're three rotations complete, coming up for the big finish in the PMAC. We hope you'll stay with us here on the ESPN SEC Network. Coming up here in the high-profile PMAC, and the Tiger fans on their feet enjoying the music and their team, who's also top 10 on floor, almost ready to roll. This has been a great meet so far, currently separated by about a point and a half. Let's take a look at Arkansas, who finished with a flourish on the floor.
Arkansas had a great floor rotation. They had nice tumbling, good landings, expressive choreography. They went 49-2, which is a really nice score. Highlighted by Lovett with a 9.9 and Carter with a 9.95, which was a career high. So now they have to go to beam and finish strong.
LSU on beam in their third rotation had a nice finish as well. Reagan Campbell with a career high 9.975. What did you see, Lori?
Well, this was a solid performance and very confident from top to bottom. This is where LSU wants to be at this point in the season, looking polished and confident. And what a huge debut performance by Shenikova, adding another layer of depth to LSU's beam lineup. And then, of course, that career finish, career high finish of a 9.975 by Reagan Campbell. Outstanding.
We've got one more break, and then the fourth rotation blasts off here in Baton Rouge. Stay with it. We'll be right back inside the Pete Maravich Assembly Center. Ion Bars at 49.525 has pushed their score after three rotations to 147.950. Great finish by Arkansas on floor. You see there now 146.475. If you'd like to get closer to the action with LSU Gymnastics, simply look at the landing. This is located on the floor of the Maravich Assembly Center. And Lori, you're right there next to Bars. The team comes out in front of you. This is just a great opportunity for everybody.
Well, this is a package deal that you can purchase for multiple people to experience a one-of-a-kind viewing experience. No one else in the country is doing this. And I've spoken to a couple people who've done this, and they said it's fabulous. There's food, there's soft seating, there's beverages, and like you said, you are right in the mix. Next to the athletes, quite often you can hear what the coaches are saying to the athletes, so it is the best spot in the arena to watch.
Kaylee, the tickets are sold out for the landing this year. They're trying to push tickets for 2021. I think this is going to be a great place for people to come see LSU Gymnastics.
Absolutely. And in a premium seating area like that, it's a no-brainer.
You see the enthusiasm on the fans' faces there. We're almost ready for our fourth rotation. LSU with one more meet coming up at home in the PMAC. That'll be against the Pac-12 power Arizona State. You see that one more home meet, 7:15 p.m. against the Sun Devils. You can get your tickets online at lsutix.net. Well, we mentioned that LSU and Arkansas, two top 10 programs nationally on floor. I think the Lady Tigers are ready to scorch the floor here, and Ruby Harreld would lead things off.
And today on floor, LSU will be without their top floor worker, Kaya Johnson. She's ranked number one in the nation. We talked about it earlier, how they are resting her, especially on this event, which is so tiresome on the legs. Courtney Goodrich will make her debut today for the Tigers.
Jessica Yamzon for Arkansas was a scratch in the floor lineup, but she will lead off for the Razorbacks here on beam in their final discipline.
Jessica is just a fantastic athlete, and she's been one of Arkansas's top athletes since her freshman year. She's nominated for the coveted AAI award at the end of this season that they'll give out. She's just a really standout athlete. You can see in her gymnastics, it's beautiful. She's powerful. She has a lot of difficulty.
Big difficulty in that tumble series where she connected three skills. So she gets a little extra bonus by connecting three skills directly.
Front toss into a beat jump.
And Arkansas has shown the most improvement on this event. The first three meets of the year, they scored a 48.775 as their average. But the last three meets, they've brought it up to a 49.175. So that's good news for the Arkansas.
Very impressive dedication to her team over the last 4 years. Yamzon didn't miss a meet for 46 straight. Now the floor lineup for LSU, and Ruby Harreld will lead things off in her senior season.
It's Ruby Harreld.
Ruby can definitely lead this floor lineup with a 9-9 to, again, set the tone for the rest of her gymnast teammates.
This is my favorite choreography for Ruby over the years. It's sophisticated but fun and sassy like her personality.
Every year has gotten better.
Opening with big difficulty, that is an E-level skill similar to a full in or a double layout, but it's front tumbling, a front double full. Moving on to her second tumbling pass, it's back tumbling, a double pike, legs are glued together, and such finesse on that landing. Gorgeous switch ring to a switch half. All the little details that will make this floor team score big. The facial expression, the passion, and the power put in every movement.
One more pass left for Ruby. She's got a great routine going so far. Full and a half to punch layout. This will be a fantastic leadoff score.
God send the queen, Ruby, for the Tigers.
Middle tumbling pass, sky high, double pike. Beautiful landing. Round off, one and a half, front layout, sticks it. But yes, I'm going to move on to my choreography. Very unique finish.
Kiara Jampanya will lead off on beam now for the Razorbacks.
Fairly solid and consistent performer for them this year. Had a mistake last week. Looking to regroup and gain some confidence with this routine. That is a required element, a full turn. She does a little bit of a unique technique. Cat leap. Slow connection, but pushes through to the front toss.
She's very calm and composed. She's supposed to connect that a little bit better. She had that chest drop and kind of scooted her feet a little bit to get the rest of that leap around. So that will definitely be a deduction. stuck the landing. Not a bad routine. Some wobbles here and there, little mistakes, but overall not bad.
Her focus was incredible throughout this routine. You could see that she was taking one skill at a time all the way through to the dismount. One and a half, almost sticks the landing.
Christina Desiderio for LSU. Congrats to Ruby Harold, who matches a career high with that 9-9 just announced.
We talked about LSU having a little bit more upgraded difficulty compared to Arkansas. Christina does a very difficult opening skill, also rated as an E, similar to Ruby's. This is a tough one. It requires so much power, and she does it so well tonight. Double layout.
And she's worked so hard on that double layout. Her chest used to be a lot down on that first tumbling pass, and they have drilled that skill, and it is beautiful.
One and a half to a front layout.
Christina's an All-American on this event. Got lots of power, lots of grace. She loves to show off this floor routine.
At this point, she's absolutely exhausted, but still keeps a smile on her face, performing to the end. Double tuck, and somehow holds it inbounds. A fun and fantastic routine.
Christina for the Tigers!
She's been 9-8-7-5 3 weeks in a row. Might have a chance to top that with that fun routine.
Opening pass, a double layout, two rotations in the laid out position, doing a great job of getting the chest up on the landing, something you said that she's been working on. Last tumbling pass, almost steps out of bound. You can step on the line, but not out. Well done in knowing exactly where she was.
Nice performance there. And for Arkansas, here's Bailey Lovett, the redshirt freshman.
And hey, look, the same mount that we saw Shenikova do. Nice job on a required full turn.
Earlier this season, Bailey got the first 9-9 on balance beam for 2024 Arkansas. So I'd say she's definitely one of their top beam workers, and you can see it in her skills and her dance, her toe point.
She has this calmness about her, but there's also a precision and an ease to her skills. Dismount, Gaynor Pike off the end of the beam, sticks the landing. Not many deductions at all in that routine. Here's that mount. It's a blind back handspring to a shoulder stand. And the dismount, a Gaynor Pike.
Lovett was an all-around champion from the state of North Carolina. And now, for the first time in her career, the freshman Courtney Goodrich, the level 10 gymnast from Orlando, takes the floor.
LSU overall has had to overcome many obstacles this year with injuries and now sickness with Kai Rivers out. But that has allowed a lot of these young athletes to step up, even walk on athletes like Courtney Goodrich and get some competition experience, and that will make them stronger in the end.
And also, we talked about earlier, exercising your depth. Courtney wasn't in the lineup, but here she is getting a chance, and they may need her in postseason again, so they want to make sure she has some experience. And so far, she's doing a great job.
Two solid passes with a double back and a one and a half to a front layout. That one and a half to a front layout meets the requirement of a double salto pass. So you have to have a pass with two saltos in it. Courtney's capable of doing even bigger difficulty at the JO level. She competed a double Arabian that was sky high. But of course, in her debut performance, they probably wanted to make sure that she was competing something that she absolutely could hit with confidence and safely.
That final tumbling pass, taking a deep breath. Landed a little short, but she recovered well. She saved that.
She's got a big cheering section just on the side of the mat. You know her teammates are so happy for her.
Opening tumbling pass, sky high, double back. Round off 1.5, little leg separation there, but not a bad job. Just that knee buckle at the end, that will be the biggest deduction.
Now Kennedy Hambrick on beam. She has a season high of 990.
It's a beautiful backhand spring layout step out. Her form was perfect, and she was spot on the balance beam. Beautiful 180-degree splits, which is, again, what the judges are looking for. We want no deductions there.
She was a big part of this Arkansas team beating Georgia earlier, narrowly by 0.2. That was a big win for this program, and especially for Jordan Weaver as the new head coach in her first year. Anytime you can beat an SEC team, especially one with so much history and strength like Georgia, that's a big win.
Absolutely. That back handspring layout step out again. Very nicely done.
Next on the floor for your Fighting Tigers, Bridget D.
And that cartwheel gainer layout full for the dismount. Very nice routine.
After starting a little slow, Hambrick finishes red hot, a 9.925. We'll see what she gets on that performance. Now Bridget Dean on floor.
Bridget Dean got a 9.8 last week on this floor routine. But she's capable of higher. She's gotten a 9.875 as her career best.
Just like on bars and beam, she has shown so much improvement. Competing three events for this very competitive Tiger team. That is impressive. And with each competition, that confidence gets bigger and better. Her routines become cleaner.
Claire Kearney Thigpen does all of the choreography for LSU. The girls spend hours in the gym over the summer with her, coming up with the perfect music, the perfect dance to really fit their personalities. And every year the routines just get better and better and more exciting to watch. And the crowd really gets into everybody's floor routines. It's their favorite event.
Amazing routine. LSU has 2.99s, a 9.575. They're hoping to be able to drop that score. This should be another big score for the Tigers. Good attention to the details on the landings, knowing exactly where she is and hitting that nice lunge. Last tumbling pass, she does the double back as her last tumbling pass, which this year gives her one extra tenth of bonus.
Kennedy Hambrick just tied a career high with a 9.925. Here's Sophia Carter.
We saw the elegance and beautiful performance in her floor routine. She has a similar look here on beam. A little slow going through that tumble series, back handspring layout. Almost under-rotated it slightly.
Sophia set the program record for the Razorbacks on beam with a 9.975 against Georgia in 2018.
Again, look at the attention to the details, especially in the arms. The extension every single time she enters and finishes a skill. The power and the reach that she has in all of her choreography in this routine. aerial into a full, sticks the landing. Outstanding.
Forsall for the Tigers, Bridget Dean.
That handspring to layout step out. Small wobble there, but she recovered. And then the dismount. Side aerial to back layout full. Sticks the landing.
Arkansas pouring it on beam, a 9-9, a 9-9-2-5, and that should be a big score from Carter as well, putting a little pressure on LSU.
This is Reagan Campbell for LSU. 9-9 is her career high on this event, and she's just beautiful to watch. Beautiful double pike. She really shows off her flexibility in this floor routine. It's so fun and exciting.
Again, one of her strengths, the flexibility, especially in those leaps. Getting well beyond that 180 degree required split position.
Final tumbling pass.
Oh dear.
She had a beautiful routine going.
Almost as if she held back just a little bit to try to get another perfectly stuck landing. Hope that her ankle is all right on that punch out of the 1.5. Opening tumbling pass was a 2.5 twist. That was the middle tumbling pass, a nice sky-high double pike with a solid landing. Another look at the double pike.
Now the anchor for Arkansas on beam, Amanda Elswick. Her career high is a 9.90.
Beautiful lift into her layout out of the back handspring for her series. Adding a little sassy performance in this beam routine. Something that UCLA coach Valerie Condos always promoted was smiling during your beam routine. She said that helps calm the nerves. And you can see that Jordan Weaver has applied that to her team here at Arkansas as well. Staying focused, into the dismount, back handspring, 1.5 twist. Nice job.
Very nice beam routine. A few wobbles here and there, but great anchor set.
Pushes through the back handspring and actually pops that layout way up in the air. Most of the athletes just whip it over and into the dismount. A 1.5, a tiny hop on the landing.
Please welcome Kennedy Edney.
Now Kennedy Edney coming to the floor for LSU.
A little bit of pressure here on Kennedy Edney, their senior veteran athlete. LSU is now forced to count their 9.575 from Courtney Goodrich after a fall, an uncharacteristic fall from Campbell.
The good news is Kennedy can put up a good score.
This is an important pass right here, and she nails it. She flew out of bounds during warm-up, but not in competition. She's a gamer.
To punch layout immediately into her dance. I love this routine for Kennedy. It fits her personality so well.
music slows down and enables her to catch her breath before her final tumbling pass. It's important that she does not get ahead of herself here. Just do the pass the way you know you can do it, not necessarily to be perfect. Excellent.
Kennedy has received a perfect 10 on this event. That could be what happens tonight. That was a pretty good flow routine.
I think you can put another all-around title on her resume. That was a great performance by her tonight.
Under pressure, the senior comes through big time. The crowd's on their feet. They want to see a 10.
Let's take a look at the replay.
Opening tumbling pass, a big E double Arabian. She finds the blind landing, huge height. I'm hearing some boos, not sure if the 10 is there. Big finish with the double back. Lots of personality in the routine.
So all four rotations in the books for LSU, and they finish with a 197-125. The 197 streak continues for the Tigers. Arkansas will finish at 195-725 overall. Let's take a closer look at Arkansas's beam scores, Lori.
Solid performance, beautiful routines from Lovett and Hambrick, scoring over a 9.9. They looked confident. They looked like a very well-prepared team over there on beam.
And for LSU on floor, they got some big numbers from Kennedy Edney as well as Christina Desiderio. Overall, a very nice, consistent night for LSU.
LSU definitely brought the energy for their last rotation on floor. They started off strong with a great routine from Ruby Harold, and they finished off with Kennedy Edney's 9.925. Overall, a great night, especially on floor for the Tigers.
So tonight's meet in the books. We'll step aside for one moment, come back, and wrap it up in the postgame and talk about what's to come in 2020 left in the regular season. 27-125 takes the victory against top 15 Arkansas here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Arkansas with a 195-725 and a big finish on floor for the Razorbacks with a 49-20. The biggest crowd in this season, over 12,000 in the PMAC, eighth biggest all time for LSU. Lori, what were your thoughts about the meet? Pretty good start to finish.
It was absolutely an exciting competition, and for LSU, just like their season, they had a lot of obstacles to overcome tonight. With their top athlete, number 2 ranked all-arounder Kaya Johnson, taking some rest and only competing on 2 events. Their other top freshman, Kai Rivers, out sick. That allowed some of the other athletes to step up, and they did so big time tonight. This was a big night in terms of LSU's preparation for the postseason. With all of those obstacles still scoring over a 197, this is big.
Kaylee, it was a tale of two Kennedys tonight, Kennedy Edney and Kennedy Hambrick, who both finished 1-2 in the all-around.
They both had a great night, and Arkansas had a decent night, too. They started off a little slow on bars with those 2 falls, but then they got it together. They had little mistakes here and there, but not a bad road score for Arkansas.
LSU will head out on the road to Denton, Texas for one more meet with Texas Women's. Arkansas will be there as well, along with Centenary, and then they're home one more time here in the PMAC against Arizona State. You can get your tickets on LSUTix.net. So LSU with a solid victory here in Baton Rouge by more than a point. An exciting night for everyone involved, for LSU and Arkansas. For Kaylee Dixon Abood and Lori Strong Ballard, I'm Garrett Walbert saying so long for Baton Rouge, Louisiana, where the final score was LSU 197-125, Arkansas 195-725.